Dead Rising 2 voor single player, multiplayer en co-op. It's a third-person perspective game and you play Chuck. Chuck has a daughter who has been bitten by a zombie, who was also your wife, and now your daughter has to take every 12 hours a Zombrex, also twice a day. In order to do that, like you found out in Case Zero on the Xbox only, the downloadable game, Zombrex needs to not turn in a zombie. So you have to give it all the tell time, and you see also in Case Zero why he has to go into Fortune City, because Las Vegas is already destroyed by the zombies, and now there's only Fortune City, a second place like Las Vegas. So Chuck, world famous motocross driver, racer, and he's going to Terror is Reality, a game show where you have to kill in an arena with three other gamers zombies. The higher you end, the more money you earn. So that's why Chuck is going to Fortune City and takes place in Tyr to earn money to buy Zombrex for his daughter. After a while, Chuck is being accused of a terrorist attack. So the zombies are walking in Fortune City all around, escaping from the arena, and in a short time the whole Fortune City is overwhelmed with zombies. So Chuck has 72 hours before the army also arrives to prove his innocence, and he has to do it and also get the Zombrex for his daughter. And yeah, of course there are psychopathic level bosses and survivors to rescue. The survivors of course don't talk, just like the first game. You see a little message text and it flops by very fast, so you have to read very quickly to understand why they won't follow you and what you have to do to make them follow you to the safe place. Of course, during the reading of the little messages, you're being assaulted by zombies. Frustrating, irritating, I didn't like it. Also, if you're looking on your watch or on your map, zombies will attack you. Irritating, frustrating. Also, it's just like the first game, it's slow. You move around slowly. Of course, if you played Xbox 360 Case Zero, you can import your character to level 5 and all its money to Dead Zero 2. And there you have your level 5 character with a lot of money and you can play with him. But also, Chuck is really slow, just like Dead Rising, the first game. He's walking around slowly, moving around slowly, and his fighting skills are slowly. And that's irritating and frustrating. It's even so irritating and frustrating that the survivors that you do rescue, they shoot with weapons, like shotguns, pistols. But they also shoot at other survivors and at you. Why? Because they're idiots in the game. There is no artificial intelligence in this game. So you have to hold the hand of the survivor and say, come on, follow me, let's go to the safe house. That's the game style, just like the first one. It's irritating, frustrating. After a while you think, I'm gonna take my little CD and I'm gonna snap it in two because I can't stand it anymore. And of course you can also make your own weapons. It's nice to have an electric shotgun or a nerf rifle with little flaming balls shooting. Of course that's fun, but to get all the ingredients and the stuff you need, you have to move around the big gigantic map and collect it and then build it. Before you get the second ingredient that you need for your weapon, your life is low, your weapons are empty, and you have to still go to the workshop and make your weapon. So that's also difficult. And then of course single player, the storyline, you have a certain few minutes for every case to solve, and of course you have to rescue survivors. So you play one time the whole game and then you play it again for the survivors. So it's just like the first one. Didn't like it so much then, because it's frustrating and irritating to do those things. Then of course, to buy Zombrex, you You have to do it on the illegal market. You need money. The money, well, you just have to play multiplayer. That's where you earn the money. In multiplayer, you take on tier. There is reality game show. You earn money, the higher you end, the more money you get, and you can use that money in single player to buy Zombrex. Of course, there's also a co-op mode. That's fun, a friend joins you, but of course, he's wearing a leather string and he's shooting, shouting around, look at me, and you're being attacked by zombies. So, it can be fun with a friend, and it can be a lot easier, but not much. And it can also be frustrating, especially if you play it with a friend who isn't helping you. So, there you go. You're forced to play multiplayer, to play single player, and there's a co-op mode, which is nice. Multiplayer is a bit boring after a while, and of course the Zombrex that you need to buy. Every time you buy Zombrex on the illegal market, the next time it will be more expensive. It doubles the price. I thought I'd go to the pharmacy, get one Zombrex ingredient. No, you can get it once, the second time it's not there. But if you kill a difficult psychopathic enemy and you go back in the store, they all respawn there. But no Zombrex. Irritating, frustrating. So, it's just like the first one, it's only the game store. The story is better, the graphics are more better, the gameplay is just like the first one, and multiplayer, co-op nice, multiplayer, boring after a while.